a pure harmony, so mellow. Sparkling streets are as bright as the smiles on the kids at SeaWorld and the zoo. The warmth in the greeting of San Diegans meeting echoes from ocean to canyon and through San Diego. Watching people as they play on their own mission, they could Juan Cabrillo have known. So proudly would we call you home, San Diego. There is a pride in your heart that sets you apart, a spirit to flourish and grow. Let nothing ever dim your glow, San Diego.
I'm Shelburne Brown, president of Point Loma College. For the next few minutes, I would personally like to introduce you to our college and to show you our picturesque campus located here on beautiful Point Loma in San Diego. We are a four-year liberal arts college offering 18 undergraduate degrees, four master's degrees, and a doctorate in education. Our present enrollment is close to 1,700, with 86 full-time faculty members, over half of whom, we're very proud to say, have earned doctorates. Come with me now as I show you the campus. Ours is a unique and different campus. It dates back to the early 1900s, when the property was owned by the Historical Theosophical Society. A few of the buildings still remain, like this one, the former home of A.G. Spaulding, a well-known name in connection with sporting goods. It presently houses our administrative offices, truly a building saturated with personality and history.
Me, sophomore math major from Visalia, California, will assist me in this historical walk around our campus, pointing out the places of interest.
Right, Dr. Brown. A perfect day for such adventure.
think the first point of interest is here at our student prayer chapel, because we are concerned with the whole person, spiritually as well as mentally and physically. I think this building tells it very well.
It was first built on our Pasadena College campus. With our move to San Diego, the student body, faculty, and friends were interested in its relocation. After many details and hard work, it was brought down in sections and rebuilt on this spot for use by the students in his special times of meditation.
That's one thing that makes us a unique and different college. We're interested in the student personally. Cheryl, you show them our science division. I'll meet you later.
Roar Science Complex, location of the Natural Science Division. Considerable time in this building because of the general education science requirements. A one-to-one relationship between faculty and students gives the division unusual success with those entering professional fields. Undergraduate, research provides the necessary background for any future objectives. Currently, research is being conducted by advanced undergraduates and faculty.
Any kind of animal, rats, for instance, man, we can determine the effects of various materials, for instance, toxins, pesticides.
Has a calculator computer laboratory where students have the opportunity to work on time-sharing terminals. Since the computer is so prevalent in our society today, the computer science option is a popular and rapidly growing major. The main goal throughout is to teach, to understand, and to use the computer both in and out of college. Working and sharing together enables the student to gain new knowledge and insight into scientific procedures. The well-equipped laboratories are indispensable to practical experience. The percentage of our students accepted into medical school is well above the national average. A number of grants over several years have made possible the purchase of sophisticated instrumentation in several departments. This allows certain students to co-author papers written for publication as a result of findings through the use of these instruments. Pacific Ocean as a perfect backdrop. Entrance into Golden Gymnasium is panoramic and impressive. Utilization of the building is threefold, with a wide variety of events held here. Our indoor chapel sessions, a time set aside from the academics, is held in the spacious gymnasium, broadening the insight of the student, making him aware of the importance religion plays in our daily lives, is an essential part of chapel.
That speak to us in our...
And what would college life be without intercollegiate sports? The roar of the crowd, the thrill of competition. A variety of sports meets the demands of the disciplined athlete. Men's and women's intramural programs open up additional arenas, providing excitement for a large number of students. The Cultural Affairs Series, available several times throughout the year, has provided enrichment for our students as well as people from the surrounding communities. Here we find artistry of many forms, appealing to all types of audiences. Concerts, plays, politicians, historians, and other speakers, name a few in these series. Various symposiums add cultural flair to college life and to all those interested in the arts. As the potter shapes the vessel, so we attempt to mold our students' character into something of lasting quality. Keller Visual Arts Center, part of the Fine Arts Division. Art itself and art forms are individually enjoyed and expressed in the department. Channeling this special interest and talent into the right avenues gives deeper appreciation and personal accomplishment. Understanding the craft of ceramics is one way to develop and express individual skills. Encouraging creativity through interpretation expands skills into visual reality. Composition through watercolor, drawing, painting, other media are all part of this growing department. Vastness of a landmark which is fascinating in its history, we find ourselves in the Greek amphitheater, built in 1901 by the Historical Theosophical Society.
Good morning, everybody.
Seating 1,500 people,
day to be gathered out here under
it has a breathtaking view of the Pacific Ocean. It was originally used for lavish drama and musical productions, especially Shakespearean plays.
And all the men and women merely players. They have their exits and entrances.
Now it provides a spectacular setting for concerts. A variety of outdoor assemblages. Including two large and special events, baccalaureate, commencement. On certain occasions, it becomes our outdoor chapel setting. Headquarters for our religion, philosophy, and social science divisions. We pause with President Brown and Cheryl in the picturesque courtyard, gaining insight into the religion department, its goals and objectives. This department is committed to careful study of the Christian faith. Vitally important is the training of our ministerial students in becoming church leaders. The inner city provides off-campus opportunities for sharing this knowledge and faith, working with children in small groups, singing, telling Bible stories, visual lessons, craft classes are some methods used in teaching.
In the Gospel
assisting
of Mark,
in local churches gives good training and experience for our students.
Many parables and teachings.
The outstanding asset of the department and the whole college is the personal guidance and counseling offered to each student. This personal guidance, available to each one, enhances an excellent climate academically as well as spiritually, making us a unique and different college.
Calling Dr. Denenberg.
Our student nursing program is practiced in a variety of hospitals, public health centers, doctor's offices, health care clinics, under the supervision of our nursing faculty. In addition to this field experience, the student's wide knowledge is gained through classroom instruction.
The depolarization or electrical...
Another way is in individualized study. Laboratory experience held on campus is most beneficial. The numerous ways this is employed is an important facet in the development of the student.
It's also important that you...
Role-playing adds to the real sensitivity this department must possess. Approved program is accredited by the National League for Nursing and the California Board of Registered Nursing. The Early Childhood Center is the laboratory school for the Division of Education and Psychology. The center allows rich field experience for students in our child development program. This major is designed to give the student an opportunity to see and study human growth and development at the early age. The center is located in a beautiful setting. Much time is spent outdoors. A playground filled with a variety of outdoor equipment, wide open spaces for games, taking walks on the campus, seeing places of beauty, and observing others in academic surroundings. For part of the day, children choose activities in either of two large classrooms, which are furnished with different play and learning materials. They're reading, sharing, listening, learning, painting, eating together, are all part of this child-student relationship included in the laboratory school experience. Last of the remaining landmarks is here at Cabrillo Hall, which was the home of Catherine Tingley, director of the Theosophical Academy. Now it is the heart of our music department. Concert Choir, one of the three major choirs, is rehearsing. Let's go inside and listen. Thank you. Ryan Library with President Brown, we arrive in the main lobby. The fully equipped library is designed to meet the students' needs on all levels of learning. The library is the marketplace for grasping knowledge, insight obtained from books, periodicals, quiet places for thought and concentration. A distinctive feature is a special library collection of works used by our theology students. Ocean view within certain study areas is eye-appealing and conducive to study. President Brown joins Dr. Val Christensen, Chairman, Division of Natural Sciences.
Hello, Dr. Christensen. You've been teaching here at Point Loma College for about 16 years now. Tell us a little of your philosophy of Christian education.
First, Christian education should provide the finest possible climate for learning. The Christian perspective enables the student to examine man in all of his relationships, including his relationship to God. This worldview helps where I feel conventional wisdom has failed, in finding purpose for life and in the search for a value system.
I know you spent some time in research in the chemical industry, and you could be teaching either in another college or university. Give us some of your reasons for being at Point Loma College.
I feel the reason relates to finding purpose in life. I think it is necessary for each individual to find some way to contribute to something of significance.
Whatever your reasons, I appreciate the fact you're here at Point Loma College and appreciate the contribution you're making to the students. Thanks a lot for your time. I want to invite you to tour the campus. See for yourself the college and its surroundings. At its reception area, you'll be given, upon request, a brochure about us, giving detailed information. Don't wait.
Echoes from ocean to canyon and through San Diego.